Ganesha should not. Yeah. At the same time,
Ganesha should understand all the
So Ganeshji should understand and write. Ganeshji, so in that time, Vyasadeva could think about what next to say. So it was like a transcendental match. So Ganeshji only wrote Bhagavad Gita. Aham sarvasya prabhuvo matha sarvam pravartate. Krishna says in 10.8, right? I am the source of both spiritual and material worlds. Who wrote this?
Ganeshji.
And mattaha parataram nanya kinchidasti dananjaya mayi sarvam idam prottam sutre manigana iva mattaha parataram nanya. So beyond me there is nothing, Krishna saying. Kinchidasti dananjaya, not even little bit. Mayi sarvam idam prottam, mayi sarvam, everything rests upon me. How? Idam prottam sutre manigana. So, yeah, we have the necklace. Which holds the necklace?
The string.
So he says, I am the string, like the string that holds the necklace. If the string is taken off,
beads
will fall off. But can the string be seen?
No.
So Krishna says, I am the string. Everything rests upon me as pearls are strung on a So, also we are going to discuss something about the glories of who? The next week we are celebrating
Radharani.
So Radharani is none other than the personal consort of the Lord. And Krishna has different shaktis. And among them, the internal potency, we have internal potency, external potency and marginal potency. So internal potency is Radharani. That's again divided into three: Ladini, Samvit, and Sandini Shaktis. So Radharani is an expansion of Krishna, expansion of Krishna's Ladini Shakti. That is, Ladini means one who gives pleasure. So that's why Krishna, Radharani is female Krishna. Because she comes from Krishna, she is an energy of Krishna also, and also she is the supermost devotee of the Lord. And if we want bhakti, we can approach Krishna through Rama, through Sita, Narayana through Lakshmi. So we always say Lakshmi, Narayana, Sita, Ram, Radheshyam. Why?
Because the mother is more merciful than the
father. Yeah. Mother is more merciful than the father, and mother's recommendation. Okay, without Radharani is the topmost devotee, and whomever Radharani recommends, Krishna is going to accept with no questions. So we approach Krishna through Srimati Radharani. In fact, when you can see that when Prabhupada was young, what many sages and devotees used to come to Prabhupada's house, and Prabhupada's father, what does he usually ask them to bless their son as? That's something, let my son become a good devotee. Especially he asked them to bless. Let my son become a servant of Srimati Radharani. So when you go to Vrindavan, what do you hear with the rikshawala? Right? They don't say Krishna Krishna. Because Vrindavan is Radharani, and through Radharani we can get Krishna, so they don't have doubts in them. And so some people may object, is Radharani mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam?
Yes.
Not directly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We will the 9th chapter, 349, 50 sokas. help of Radharani, we get the mercy of Krishna. Otherwise, there is no way. This is Bhagavad Gita.
Yeah, Bhagavad Gita 9. Mahatmanastu Mahatmanastu. Yeah, and also in Srimad Bhagavatam, she is not directly mentioned, but indirectly mentioned. What does Sukadeva Goswami mention?
That Lord Krishna disappeared from the middle of the Rasa dance and was seen, and when the gopis were searching for him, they saw the footprints of Sri Krishna and another gopi. And the name is not mentioned, but the Leela is mentioned. They're walking, and then Oh, Sati, this is where he must have picked her up to pick the flower.
Yeah. So, Radharani means one who does the best Aradhana, the best worshipper of the Lord. And one who sacrifices everything for the Lord. Right? Gopis, they are not in any way in relation to the Lord to claim anything of the Lord. But they are always in the mood of service and sacrifice without expecting anything else. So of them, Radharani embodies the topmost trophy.
Yes, one more verse from, can you go to Anand Rasapratibhavita?
That's also from Brahma Samhita, where Brahma is saying, who is Radharani? Who are the gopis?
Ananda Chinmaya.
Ananda Chinmaya Rasa Pratibhavita. Let's all recite together. Ananda
Chinmaya Rasa Pratibhavita. Tavirya eva nijarupataya kalabhi Goloka eva nivasatya vinyamabhuto Govindamani purusham tamaham prajami.
Anyone synonymous and translation?
Ananda, bliss, chit and knowledge, maya consisting of rasa, mellows, prati, every second, bhavitabhi, who are engrossed with, tabhihi, tabhihi, with those, yaha, who, eva, certainly, nijarupataya, with his own form, akalabhihi, who are parts of, portions of his pleasure potency, goloke, in goloka vrindavan, eva, certainly, nivasati, resides, Akhilatma, as the soul of all, Bhuta, who exists, Govindam, Govinda, Adipurusham, the original personality, Tam, him, aham, I, bhajami, worship. I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord, residing in his own realm, Goloka, with Radha, resembling his own spiritual figure, the embodiment of the ecstatic potency, possessed of the 64 artistic activities in the company of her confidants or sakhis, embodiments of the extensions of her bodily form, permeated and vitalized by his ever blissful spiritual rasa.
This Brahma Samhita was commented, translated by Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. That's why you see the English from the previous century. It's a big purport. But essentially, you see, although the Lord Absolute and His potency are one and the self-same existence, still they exist eternally as separate entities, as Radha and Krishna. In both the ecstatic energy and the transcendental Lord Krishna, there exists Shringar Rasa, amorous love whose quality is inconceivable. And then he's explaining the different artistic,
64 colors.
Yeah, 64 colors. Can you scroll down?
All
the 64. So with this, because the translation has now, she's possessing of 64 artistic and then how they are meant for, they are exhibited in the pastimes of Praja by the spiritual potency. And it is to, Lord is having this Leela. Okay, Lord is full of, Krishna is called Rasaraj. Rasaraj means?
The Lord of Rasa.
The Lord of Rasa, reservoir of all Rasa. Right, so how much enjoyment he should have? So the Lord is completely spiritual, how will he enjoy something material? So that thing that interests the Lord, that entertains the Lord, that bewilders the Lord, is completely spiritual potency of the Lord. So Radha Krishna is called Madan Mohan and Radharani is called Madana Mohana Mohini. One who is deluding, the one who deludes the Cupid. Madan Mohan is deluder of Cupid. Madan Mohan Mohini is deluder of those who deluder of Cupid. Okay. So Prabhupada, we'll go to Krishna book. Chapter. Can you open the Krishna book contents? The chapter after Uddhava visits Vrindavan. You can come, scroll down.
After that,
47, delivery of the message of Krishna to the gopis. So, of course, Prabhupada clearly mentions that this Radha and Krishna are completely spiritual, and whatever is going on between Radha Krishna and the gopis are nothing to be compared to the mundane world. And Srila Prabhupada, if you see, he has not spoken much on this. When someone asked him to speak also, he said no, because we are not qualified. But because of Radhashtami, you know, we are going to discuss something from Krishna book. So, Krishna left Vrindavan when? Who came and picked Krishna for what? Akrura.
Akrura.
To go to Mathura. And Kamsa was thinking, I will kill Krishna. But Krishna had to deliver Kamsa. And then did he come back?
No.
So that is the first time whom is he's meeting. I mean, Vasudeva Devaki, right? They saw their newborn child Krishna go away. Then when he's coming back, he's 10 years. So Krishna is asking forgiveness from Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj. Nanda Maharaj is stunned. Oh Krishna, Balaram, you're not going to come with us back. How will I go back without you? But then they are falling at Nanda Maharaj's feet and asking that I have to do my duties. We have not been fortunate enough to serve Yashoda and Vasudeva and Devaki, our parents, so we want to serve them and please kindly excuse us. We will serve them and immediately come back. But after Kamsa, then Jarasandha, then so many other things, then Dwaraka fort, so Krishna was not able to go to Vrindavan back, but he sent Uddhava. Uddhava is Krishna's friend and cousin, who looks exactly like Krishna. So, and the previous chapter is Uddhava coming to Vrindavan, and Uddhava is delivering the message to Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj. And then it is said that Nanda Maharaj is asking about Krishna's well-being. How is he? Is he thinking about us? Is he thinking about his friends, his gopis? And then what is Yashoda Mai talking? There is no mention. She was constantly crying, thinking about the Lord, hearing what Nanda Maharaj is saying. Then Uddhava is coming to gopis because Krishna has sent a message to gopis. And so gopis are seeing, who is this boy? He looks very much like Krishna only. His features are exactly like Krishna and Uddhava. They are thinking, who is this person who has come from Skrona? And so then when they understood that Krishna had sent them a message, I mean, a message from the Supreme Lord whom they're constantly thinking about. They are very, very happy. So then they are, you know, started speaking to him that, does he think about all of us? And he's now a man in Mathura. He's a king. There are so many people around him. And like that. So, yeah, from his Govardhan. We are just going to read some parts of it. And then they are telling, you know, how they know that Krishna is very much attached to them in Madhurya Rasa. But, you know, this is the dealings of Krishna and gopis. So they are telling that how will he ever think about us? He has so many people to think about now. And, you know, even the family members we forget. What to speak about friends and relations outside of that. So we can see the line of love, hidden love, and the intimacy that they are talking to about the Lord, right? Why will he even think of us like that? Then they are indirectly accusing Krishna that he just came here, he took our hearts and he went away and he's not even bothered to return us. So this is what the last verse of Shikshashtaka. What is that? Ashishya va padaratan vinastu ma adarshana marmahata karotuva yata tatava vidatatu lampatu. O mischievous naughty boy, matprana natastu saiva napraha. Whether you give me your darshan or you make me wait forever without even seeing you, you are free to do anything and everything, but you are my worshipable Lord. Yeah, we scroll down. So then, what did Uddhava? Yeah, can you read that? Uddhava understood that the gopis of Vrindavana were all simply absorbed in the thought of Krishna and his childhood activities. While talking about Krishna with Uddhava, they forgot all about their household business. They even forgot about themselves as their interest in Krishna increased more and more. Uddhava came with a message, but Uddhava finally, he said, what was Uddhava's prayer was, let me be grass in Vrindavan on whom the gopis would trample. So while he was talking to gopis like this, there is one gopi, namely Srimati Radharani, who wasn't even talking to Uddhava. The other gopis were talking to Uddhava. But Radharani is talking to a bumblebee. That's why it's called Brahmargeet. Right? Talking to the bumblebee, thinking of bumblebee as the messenger of Krishna. So first, you know, she's accusing Krishna like this. Bumblebee.
Someone can read. Bumblebee, you're accustomed to drinking honey. And therefore you have preferred to be a messenger of Krishna. Who is of the same nature as you? I can see you on your moustaches, the red powder of kurkuma, which was smeared on the flower garland of Krishna, while it was pressed against the breasts of some other girl who is my competitor. You feel very proud because of having touched that garland and your moustaches have become reddish. You have come here carrying a message for me, anxious to touch my feet, but my dear bumblebee, let me warn you, don't touch me. I don't want any messages from your unreliable master. You are the unreliable servant of an unreliable master.
So such is the intimacy of Radharani and Krishna. So indirectly, Prabhu, indirectly she is telling to Uddhava that you are also as unreliable as your master Krishna. And she is also telling specific reasons why is she dissatisfied with Krishna. Like Mother Yashoda, right? Who else can show the stick to Krishna? And Krishna would be afraid of her. We know that in Damodar Leela. So that's the right of devotees in Vatsalya Rasa and Madhurya Rasa. So So now here Radharani is telling that what all he did in the previous previous incarnation. So his Radharani is none other than Lakshmi. So after telling that he's an unreliable master, she is telling, but the problem is we are not able to not think about this unreliable master. So we can see the contradiction in this. And then she's, you know, kind of scolding the bumblebee that you are trying to get award from me for carrying a message from such an unreliable master. That's not going to happen. And she's telling what is the position of the gopis. So we have left everything for Krishna, and it is said that Radharani would run in the night to meet Krishna, but it's completely pitch dark. And then there are snakes. On the hoods of the snakes there are jewels. And with that jewels, the light, she runs to meet Krishna. So all the other gopis are like snakes, and then she's running to meet Krishna. So she says here, you see, in this paragraph we can see that how she's the contradictions of the Lord. Can someone read? I can understand that paragraph.
I can understand that you are an expert in reuniting two opposing parties. But at the same time, you must know that I cannot place my reliance upon you, nor upon your master, Krishna. We left our husbands, children, and relatives only for Krishna, yet he did not feel any obligation in exchange. At last, he has left us for long. Do you think we can place our faith in him again? We know that Krishna cannot live for a moment without the association of young women. Because of his nature, he is finding difficulty in Mathura, because he is no longer in the village of among innocent coward girls. He's in an aristocratic society and must be feeling difficult in making friendships. Perhaps you come here to canvass again and or to take us there. But why should Krishna expect us to go there? He is greatly qualified to entrance all other girls, not only in Vrindavan or Mathura, but all over the universe. His wonderful, enchanting smile is so attractive, and the movements of his eyebrows are so beautiful that he can call for any woman from the heavenly middle of platonic planets. Even Mahalakshmi, the goddess of fortune, the greatest of all goddesses of fortune, hankers to render him service. In comparison to all these women of the universe, what are we? We are very insignificant.
So we can see what the paragraph starts with and what she ends with. If you come here to canvass me to go to Krishna, we are not coming. But finally she says, who are we to Krishna? We are insignificant. Krishna can attract anyone and everyone. So, So the next paragraph, she's telling about how Krishna was in the just for the sake of time. So she's telling he came as Ramachandra, and then Shurpanaka was coming to ask him to accept her, but he was so much hell-bent with Mother Sita that she disfigured Shurpanaka. Then in the previous thing, he was Vamanadev. Bali Maharaj gave him everything, but still he ripped him off from all the opulence and sent him to Patala Loka. So how can we trust him? So like this. Then she's saying at the end, we gopis of Vrindavana do not want to make any more friendships with a blackish boy. But we do not know how we shall be able to give up remembering and talking about his activities. So, what is her ultimately, that Krishna is so attractive. That is what Radharani's message is. In my opinion, can someone tell?
In my opinion, Srimati Radharani continued, one should not hear about Krishna because as soon as a drop of the author of these transcendental activities is poured into the ear. One immediately raised about the duality of attraction and rejection, being completely freed from the contamination of material attachment. One gives up attachment for this material world, including family, home, wife, children, and everything else materially dear to every person. Being deprived of all material equation, one makes his relative and himself unhappy. Then he wandered in search of Krishna, either as a human being in other species of life, even as a bird, and voluntarily accept the profession of mendicant. It is very difficult to actually understand Krishna, his name, his qualities, his form, his pastime, his and his
So is she glorifying Krishna or accusing here?
Glorifying.
Why? What's wrong with, I mean, everybody is materially attached, that's true. But why can't we continue like that?
Because it's temporary.
It's temporary. And if we don't develop attachment to Krishna, then we risk coming back again. And coming back again and again and again. And again, and again, and again, and again, and again. Unlimited number of lives, unlimited number of times, and we are going to suffer here. But if we are able to develop an attachment for Krishna, then we are safe. So Radharani is saying, even if we hear a little bit about Krishna, by his mercy, we will be able to develop an attachment for him. So although she is like accusing here, she is glorifying the Lord. Okay, so she is telling to the bee, probably scroll down, that I don't want to hear anything about Krishna or his message from you. I'm done with him. So like this, when she says, the bee seems to have flown away. So she's thinking, oh, the bee has taken this message of her and gone to Krishna. So immediately what's happening is she's thinking that Krishna must be very sorry to hear that. Whatever I told, this bee is going to relate to Krishna. And Krishna is going to think, oh, Radharani is speaking like this. And that will make him feel very sad. What did I do? So she went into another kind of ecstasy. Now the bee again came. Then she thought that Krishna is very kind to me. Even though I sent very, not at all good messages to him, he has still sent the bee back to me. So she is telling, my dear friend, I welcome you. Krishna is so kind that he has again sent you. Krishna is so kind and affectionate to me that he has fortunately sent you back in spite of your carrying my message against him. All good fortune to you, my dear friend. Now you may ask from me whatever you want. I shall give you anything because you are so kind to me. You have come to take me to Krishna because he is not able to come here, being surrounded by new girlfriends in Mathura. But you are a tiny creature. How can you take me there? How will you be able to help me meet Krishna while he is taking birth there to the goddess of fortune and embracing her to his chest? Never mind. Let us forget all these things about my going there or sending you. Please let me know how Krishna is faring in Mathura. Tell me if he still remembers his foster father Nanda Maharaj, his affectionate mother Yashoda, his cowherd friends and his poor friends like us, the gopis. I am sure he must sometimes sing about us who serve him just like maid servants without any payment. Is there any possibility that Krishna will come back and place his Aguru Sekhar's hand on our heads? Please put all these inquiries to Krishna. So this was her ecstasy. You see, suddenly her mood is changing and she's talking that. And then Uddhava is... So you see, this is what. Uddhava was standing there and he heard Radharani talking in this way as if she had become almost mad for Krishna. He was exceedingly surprised at how the gopis were accustomed to thinking of Krishna constantly in the topmost ecstasy of Mahabhava love. He had brought a message in writing from Krishna, but now he wanted to present it before the gopis just to pacify them. So he's saying, actually, can you scroll down to this? So he's, Uddhava is actually reading the message from Krishna instead of them. Uddhava is actually praising gopis first because he's shocked to see the level of their attachment and absorption. But gopis were not interested to hear about their exalted position. Gopis want to see what is the message written by Krishna. See, how did Krishna write? Okay, that is this paragraph. Can anyone read? Uddhava did not deliver.
Uddhava did not deliver to the gopis the written message brought from Krishna. But he personally read it to them. The message was very gravely written, so that not only the gopis but all empiric philosophers might understand how pure the God is, intrinsically integrated with all the different energies of the Supreme Lord. From Vedic information, it is understood that the Supreme Lord has multi energy. All the gopis were such intimate personal friends of Krishna that while he was writing the message for them, he was so moved that he could not write distinctly. Uddhava was a student of Gurdwara, had very sharp intelligence. So instead of handing over the written message, he thought and then before his learning of read it personally and explain it.
So what is special in this paragraph? So, how come the gopis could read the message themselves? So, Uddhava is whose disciple?
Brihaspati.
And he is expert. So, instead of handing over this intelligible handwriting, which Krishna was moved, he wasn't able to write properly. So, he thought, let me read the message to them. So, Uddhava continued, these are the words of the personality of Godhead. My dear gopis, my dear friends, please know that separation between ourselves is impossible at any time, at any place, or under any circumstances, because I am all-pervading. So, Krishna is first saying that we are not separated. I am there and you are there. Even Prabhupada explains that. We'll scroll down to me. How in the 9th chapter, the 7th chapter, that Krishna is present everywhere, his absolute nature, his energies, and so even the elements are not separated from the Lord. And then he's continuing to read, Uddhava continued reading Krishna's message. Nothing is separate from me. The whole cosmic manifestation is resting on me and is not separate from me. Before the creation, I was existing. So how Krishna was existing before the creation, how he put the living entities in this material world, how after everything also he's the one who's going to continue to exist like that. You know, after each line of Krishna, Prabhupada is explaining what it means and why Krishna has written the book. So Prabhupada, scroll down.
Sorry,
for lack of time, but
it's very
good. Yeah. Uddhava continuing Krishna, reading Krishna's message. Can someone read?
Uddhava continued reading Krishna's message. Transcendental knowledge of the Absolute is no longer necessary for you. You are accustomed to loving me from my very beginning of your lives.
So that's an explanation of what Krishna wrote. So his gopis' knowledge, for knowledge has to culminate in bhakti, right? Bahuna janmana mante jnana manma prapadyate vasudeva sarvabhuti sa mahatma sudhyama. After many, many lifetimes of jnana, a person surrenders that Vasudeva is everything. But the gopis are always absorbed in the thoughts of Vasudeva. So you don't need any knowledge because you have attained the end of knowledge, Krishna is telling. And this is God. The gopis are in the perfect stage of meditation. What is the verse that Krishna says who is the best yogi? In the 6th chapter, end of the 6th chapter. Of all the yogis,
one who is absorbed in me is the
best. One who is absorbed in me, I consider him to be the best. Yoginam api sarvesham madgate nantaratmana. Not just superficially thinking. He's telling madgate antaratmana. One who is constantly thinking of me within the core of his heart. Shraddhavan bhajate yoma. He always worships me. Same yukta tamo vasha. He is the best according to me. So Krishna is telling to gopis that you are the best. Because you are always absorbed in me. And then Lord Chaitanya, what he taught? Lord Chaitanya taught people in general the method of Vipranatha Seva, which is the method of rendering service unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the feeling of separation. So the Goswamis, you know, people ask Prabhupada, did you see Krishna? Prabhupada said, our job is not to see Krishna, but our job is to act in such a way that Krishna sees us. So the gopis, he Radhe Braja Devike Chalalite, he Nandashuno Kuta, Shri Govardhana Kalpa Pada Patale Kalindi Mane Kuta. Kuta, where is Radharani? He Radhe Braja Devike, he Lalita, he Nandashuno. So where are you, Krishna? You see, when the last three lines, when they lived in Vrindavan, they were searching for Krishna, crying. Where are you, Krishna? Oh, gopis, where are you? Where are you, Srimati Radharani? They never said, we have now seen Radha and Krishna, and therefore our mission is fulfilled. Their mission remained always unfulfilled. They never met Radha and Krishna. So this is the mood that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is showing us. How to serve Krishna in always feeling of separation, always longing to meet the Lord. So the gopis are, you know, continuing that what all Krishna did when he was with them. And this is Leela Smarana. Leela Smarana means thinking about the activities of the Lord and constantly absorbed. For them, the Lord did not leave Vrindavan at all. Because in one sense, the Lord never left their mind. They are always absorbed in the Lord, in separation. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thought that is the best thing, without even expecting whether I will meet the Lord, whether the Lord will come and give his darshan. They were continuing their devotional service in longing and separation. So finally, Uddhava's message. Uddhava's message is an instruction, save the gopis from immediate death. Because they were constantly in the verge of dying, thinking about the Lord. And the gopis acknowledged the benediction from Uddhava. Uddhava practically acted as the preceptor, spiritual master of the gopis, and in return they worship him as they would worship Krishna. It is recommended in authoritative scripture that the spiritual master be worshipped on the level of the Supreme Personality of Godhead because of being his very confidential servitor. And it is accepted by great authority that the spiritual master is the external manifestation of Krishna. The gopis were relieved from their transcendental burning condition by realizing that Krishna was with them. Internally, they remembered his association within their hearts, and externally, Uddhava helped them associate with Krishna by his conclusive instructions. Yeah, can we scroll down? Uddhava continued. Can you read? Someone can read that with this.
Uddhava continued. The supreme benediction attained by the gopis is, in spite of their being born in the families of gopas and they never attained even by the goddess of fortune and certainly not by the images of heaven through the body sense of the women. There is exactly like the scent of the lotus. The gopis are so fortunate that during the Rasalila, Krishna personally embraced them with his arms and kissed them face to face. Certainly it is not possible for any woman in the three worlds to achieve this except the gopis. Therefore, I wish to take birth as one of the plants sleepers in Vrindavana who are so fortunate that the gopis trample them. The gopis have so lovingly served Krishna, Mukunda himself, the giver of liberation, who is searched after by great sages and saintly persons. For his sake, they left everything, their families, their children, their friends, their homes, and all worldly connections.
So this is the Uddhava's conclusion, that let me become a plant or a creeper that gopis can trample. But he did not ask them directly because they wouldn't be agreeable. So that's why he says, let me become a grass so that they will trample upon me, and that way I will get the dust. So then he when Uddhava had been fully honored and worshipped by the pure devotees of Vrindavana, he returned to Mathura and his master Krishna. After offering respects by bowing down before Lord Krishna and Balarama, he described the wonderful devotional life of the inhabitants of Vrindavana. Then he presented to Vasudeva, Krishna's father, and Ugrasena, Krishna's grandfather, all the gifts given by the inhabitants of Vrindavana. So this is the glories of the gopis. And Krishna, I mean, we might wonder why Krishna disappeared from the Rasalila, right? When there was gopis and Radharani. The gopis wanted to glorify the supreme position of Radharani among themselves. So as we saw in the Brahma Samhita verse, the gopis are none other than the expansions of Radharani herself. So why? They were feeling that how are we dancing with Krishna on a level equal to Radharani. And they had a desire to glorify Radharani's supreme position, and that's why Krishna took Radharani and went from the Rasalila that the gopis were asking. And in fact, in that, then Krishna left Radharani also, right? The gopis were searching, and then they found that Radharani is alone crying. So I heard in the lecture that Radharani was thinking, how can I enjoy separately with Krishna? I should have all my friends. So this is the competition there, how to serve Krishna and the others better. So there is no tinge of any mundane, you know, feelings or lust or anger or anything, but unconditional service. So we will, I mean, these are the few things that we can meditate on. during this auspicious Radhashtami and we will pray to the dust of the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani and the gopis so that we might be blessed with devotion to Krishna and the Vrajavasis. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Anybody has any questions? Why? Because we saw now in the drama, Narada Muni is thinking who is the best of all the devotees. And Narada Muni, when he always has a question in the mind and he goes to Vaikuntha, Narayana performs a pastime so that that question in Narada Muni's mind is getting clear. So Narada Muni came to Dwaraka to ask Krishna, and then Krishna made this pastime of headache. Krishna is having a headache, and who would give the dust? Anybody would give the dust. It's not about going to hell, but again, one more point is that gopis love, because of being in Madhurya Rasa, is so intimate that it is crossing the level of all reverence. Iti Triksha Leela Vid Ananda Kunde Swagosham Vimajantam Akyapayantam Tadiye Shitakne Shubhaktai Jitatvam Puna Prema Tastam Sarata Priti Vande. So he's telling that I am controlled by the love that is crossed over all reverence. We cannot do that at our level because we still don't even have all reverence to the Lord. But that is their, you know, glories. So Narada Muni is wanting to glorify this. And Krishna is inviting us. Why all this is given in Krishna?
Actually, recently we were in Vrindavan. We went for the Govardhan Parikrama. In one of the temples there, I forgot which one, Lord Shiva is dressed as one of the gopis to come and see the Rasa Leela. So he is given. So in that, actually, the beautiful, you can actually find out because there is a snake in one of the gopis. But he is only allowed to watch from a distance. He is not allowed to participate because the level of devotion of the gopis is like considered even much higher than Lord Shiva. I mean, that's what they describe.
Yeah, so we are very, very fortunate. Rajaswama, my world is not like this. When you come to me, you never come back here. We go there and do what? Engage in serving the Lord in different moods according to what the Lord wants us to serve in us. So that's why this Krishna book is full of details of what devotees are doing in Krishna's world, so that we get attracted to that and then we make that as an aim of life.
So when meditating on the gopis and Krishna pastimes, can we increase our...
Yes, that's what Sukriya Goswami says also. You know, if you read that again and again, but we have to see also that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu listened again and again to Prahalad and Dhruva Charitra more than, you know, Gopi's Charitra. So we read everything. Not there are some maybe, I mean, according to what Srila Prabhupada taught us, we read Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna book, Nectar of Devotion. Again, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam. Continuously chanting throughout our lives. Our life is filled with so much nectar of chanting and reading, and so much to read, so much to observe, so much to understand.
We are not yet ready to read Gopi Gita and all.
We can read whatever Krishna book has given and Srimad Bhagavatam has given. Gopi Gita, we can read, but we may not be able to understand the intimate pastimes. So all this information is in where? Where are we getting this from? Srimad Bhagavatam. If Srimad Bhagavatam was not there, we don't even know the name Krishna now. Neither Krishna's Vrindavan pastimes. It's not from little Krishna we know. Everything comes from this book, Srimad Bhagavatam. So that's why it's important for every house to have this set of Srimad Bhagavatam. Because Srimad Bhagavatam is none other than Krishna personified. So Krishna's peak, to Krishna's forehead, is from first canto to fourth canto. So when we Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya, Bhagavati, so when we do Bhagavata Seva every day, Bhagavatam, then we get fixed in the devotion to the Lord, unshakably. And that's the goal of life. Because how can we meditate on something without constantly having a sadhana to hear? Right? So chanting and reading Srimad Bhagavatam is very, very important aspect, and that's why this time we are promoting Srimad Bhagavatam every house. Like, make America great again. We want to make America great again. Every house in America should have Srimad Bhagavatam.
Mataji, I have a question also. So, what do you think, in your opinion, the relation between bhakti and sakti? Because Arjun was devotee, also he was a soldier, and he fought the war. Lord Krishna also says, Tasmat Sarvesu Kaleshu, Maam Anusara Yuddhacha. So we are not only Anuswar him, also fight. So with my past visit, this visit of about 3 months, I deplore the situation of Hindus in India. In India I'm talking. Forget about other countries. So if we only take the path of bhakti and we forget sakti, what do you think? Where are we headed?
That's not what Krishna told you, according to you.
No, he said only, right? He said that Maam Anusmara Yuddhacha. So fight also. Anuswar, remember me and fight also. For Dharma. To protect Dharma.
That's true.
So what do you think? How can we be bhakti and sakti both? So devotion, and Arjuna was a bhakta also, and he was a kshatriya also. So kshatriya and Vaishnava, we should have two parts into it, at least in my mind. So what do you think we should draw the line, that kshatriya part in me and Vaishnava part in me?
Actually, Krishna chose Arjuna because he is the perfect instrument. Krishna is telling, no, 11th chapter, nimitta matram.
Yes, he is
Bhavasabhya Sachin. So from this we can understand, if we make ourselves a perfect instrument of the Lord, Krishna will execute his wishes through us. So first of all, we have to make ourselves a perfect instrument of the Lord. The Lord can, like just the Lord picked Arjuna to tell all this. So perfect instrument means sadhana and service, everything. So we need to do sadhana ourselves, because then we will lose in our fight to Maya. And then we can help, you know, others. So why are we pushing this Bhagavatam? It's a fight for Dharma. We are telling people, you know, you go to one vacation to Florida, $2,000 gone. This is only $275, and that too, that's for 18 books. And why we are getting the book, they'll say, oh, if I get the books, how will I read? But if you don't get the books, how will you read? If you get the books, at least you will read. Because the books are there, and then there is a vibration from the book. We get so many nice, if someone says that pay me $200 and get this nice looking gem, and if you tie it in your thing, then all the evil influences will go, there will be a huge queue for that. Because we want positive vibrations, right? How will there not be positive vibrations coming from the set of books which has been personally spoken by the Lord, Rishis, the devotees, and so much katha. Okay, Mula is given there, not only English, the Sanskrit verses are also given there. So how will it not be positive vibration? Even if you just keep the books, they are going to emanate such energy and such positive vibrations that we will feel peaceful within our heart. There are so many, many you know, instances that we know, even in our limited contact in Charlotte, that somebody in Bhadra Purnima, every devotee is breaking their head how to distribute this book. So they will send one book set as a gift to the relative. And then this big book has come what to do, put it in the book rack. And then dust the book rack, and every time when they dust the book rack, they feel bad. What is this book? I am not even reading. She said, I dusted the book. And because I served Bhagavatam like that, she opened and she read, and then she became a devotee. And her personal problems were solved also because she became a devotee. That was hanging around in her head for 10 years. So that is the glory of Srimad Bhagavatam. So not only that bhakti makes us a warrior for dharma ourselves. And then when you are a warrior, obviously, you know, you will fight for the right cause.
Yes, yes, one, two, three. So, I mean, even in the slogan, the Ananya Ashtinta, he's saying when we are in constant remembrance of Krishna, both he will give us what we need and also protect what we already have. I think in a way that addresses that question in your opinion, because if you are in constant remembrance of him, if for example our need is that energy or power, he would give that. That's the way I interpret it.
Externally, Prabhu, that is internally or
externally? Also externally.
Externally,
I mean,
how?
Because that's what he's saying, I'll give you what you need. Right? So, I mean, that's my interpretation.
Yeah, that's good.
It will come. Okay, so anything else? Any other points? Okay, so we will finish here. So we request everyone, please. Let us have Srimad Bhagavatam, please get it, you have a big treasure. We will come to read that, right? Jayanti Mataji was there in that comment. We read three cantos in a couple of 2-3 months. And we are reading Bhagavad Gita now, 8:30 to 9 is Monday to Friday. You can all join and call. After reading Bhagavad Gita, we start Bhagavatam. So we will help you read that, and you know, the kids can also read that. Ultimately, we all will be benefited 100%. So, we have one family who is getting Srimad Bhagavatam here. Shreyansh, Shalini, Madhuri. We have this set?
Yeah.